What's up, guys? Ooh. What's your channel?
It's Potgons.
Potgons. This is Zabir Bakhtian.
I'm
All right. What is up? We are in Amersfoort in the Netherlands. I found this very nice parking for the camper vans, which I have to figure out how to pay. But apparently, it sounds like it's about 12 euros. I guess this is showing the map where you can find or you can pay, something like that. Or even it's showing there is like more space that you can do this. So I gotta find out how to pay this thing before I receive a fine. And then we will be taking a walk around this beautiful, beautiful historical town, which I truly love from looking at the pictures. Now I'm here. After walking for a while, I figured out finally how to pay, that there is an app. It is called CamperPay. You gotta download that and make an account, and then through that you can pay. And I paid for here 12 euros and 60 cents for 24 hours, which is pretty sweet to be almost in the center and have your camper with you and pay it here. In case if you are into visiting this place and you have a camper, this can be really helpful. So now that we are finished with the paying, the parking, and we will be taking a walk into the town.
Daarom is de actie die op jou uitvalt.
bikers in the Netherlands are in rush. Now we are gonna go over the bridge and just take a look at the door from a different angle. This town is gorgeous, very gorgeous. Hello. No, not yet. I'm recording.
I'm recording.
Yeah, yeah.
For YouTube.
Yes, that's for YouTube. Camera. What is
Yo.
Up, guys? What's your channel?
It's Potgrond.
Potgrond. This is Zabir Paktian. Am I? Is it live?
Yes.
Yeah, yeah.
Cool.
On Twitch.
Yo, guys, what is up?
Is your YouTube channel?
Zabir Paktian.
Can you type it in?
Yeah, sure.
But you only do videos?
Yeah, yeah. I do this one.
Ah, nice. Oh. 24k!
Insane. Wow.
Dames en heren, dit moeten we kijken. Den Bosch Nederland walking tour 4K. Sick.
Oh, je hebt zo tours through cities in Holland.
Yes, yes. Oh. Everywhere.
Everywhere.
Yes, yes, yes. Oh, okay, yeah. Tell your channel too.
It's on Twitch, twitch.tv/potgrond. P-O-T-G-R-O-N-D.
Okay, nice seeing you guys.
And twitch.tv/gongbongdave. G-O-N-G-B-O-N-G Dave. Follow me on Twitch.
Okay. Yeah, nice. Take care.
Okay,
take care.
Thank you, man.
Yeah, yeah. Cheers. Also YouTube, look at all the YouTubers are here.
Do you want to make a picture with us?
Yeah, sure, why not? Let's go.
We do a city tour.
Ah, nice, me too.
I'll take a picture of you. Yeah, but okay. The city tour, yeah. The guided one.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
This is the craziest picture ever. Oh, look at that. Wicked. Wicked, wicked.
Very nice.
Yeah.
With beer.
Thank you. It was always a struggle whenever I was making these walk videos. Of course, Cretan Greece is kinda, I know a lot, so I don't get lost. But in the Netherlands, I always couldn't really find the right path and the right way to walk and to see and explore interesting stuff. So what I did, I tried like the Google Maps, I tried the iPhone Maps, and I tried everything. Nothing worked. I had the Gaia map application in my phone, but it was not a paid version. So I purchased it. Now I have some extra functionalities, and I made the entire path in that application. I'm not familiar with application so well, but I could make it work. So all the information for this walking path, the GPX data and the KLM data, something like that, I will, in simple words, I will leave the path, the exact path that I'm walking, in the description, so you guys can really, really enjoy this town. I've spent like hours and hours making this path, so it definitely is going to be something that you are gonna like if you take this path, and you are already watching it, so it will be much easier for you to follow. Yeah. Without the app, I wouldn't be able to find this little corner and this wall. If you have been to the Netherlands before and you visited only Amsterdam and Rotterdam and Den Haag, well, you've been missing on a lot. I can understand those cities, they have still their charms, but cities like this, it's called Amersfoort, this it really has that calm, quiet, clean, like kinda original Dutch feel and vibe to it, that you can see how quiet and calm and smooth things are. So for you to have a taste like that, I'm looking at the maps, for you to have a real Dutch taste and to get familiar with some of the Dutch architecture, like from the 1400, from 1600, this city is a wonderful city. Not just about the architecture, about how beautiful and calm it is, and the vibes and the smell. It's very green and it's amazing. I highly recommend visiting this city, this town. I think, yeah, it could be a city, but compared to Amsterdam and Rotterdam, it kind of feels and sounds like a town, but still it is a city. I don't know. So we have a restaurant here. Right now I am standing in front of another entrance of the town or the city. I could easily get in and get myself spoiled with all of those things, but it's a different thing when you take your time, you go around the town such as this one, which has a very circular and almost a heart-shaped style to it. It's nice to kind of slowly work your way towards the center, and that's what we are exactly doing. And if you would do the same, I'm pretty sure you're gonna have a much more profound and better experience. But if you are thirsty and you wanna jump right in, nobody is stopping you, just go for it. But always a little bit play and a little bit patience is good. A little bit foreplay perhaps wouldn't hurt. I guess that's the right word. Now we are getting closer towards a little bit kind of the shopping and fast food part of the town. As you can see, things are getting busier. There are bus stops, traffic lights and everything, and malls over there. So yeah, from here on it's gonna be getting slowly busier, and slowly we will be figuring out and exploring this beautiful town, Amersfoort. It's not Amersfoort, it's Amersfoort. It's gonna take me a while to learn the ways things work here. I almost got hit twice by a bicycle, but not by a bicycle, by many bicycles. We're standing again right on the edge of entering the town, but we're still not gonna enter. We are gonna anticipate. Nobody is walking through this place. I don't know why. It is Amisitia Boulevard, something like that. Let's go out of here. One thing is for sure that I understood by now. Whenever I used to tell my name to foreigners like Zamir, they will be saying like Zamir, and they will be saying weird ways, you know what I mean? And now I get it. It is not easy. Now that I'm finding myself in different cultures, I'm struggling the same way. So yeah, I was like, come on, they are not like just pronouncing, saying my name the right way because they want to not say it. But now I know, no, that's not the case. Yeah. So whatever I had for you guys who couldn't say my name, I forgive you. Over there we have a barber shop. Here we have a gelato place. Thank you. Paper in cartoon, PMD, Restaff Wall. We have various brands here, such as like H&M and C&A. I figured that things are a little bit different here in the Netherlands. On Monday, on the first day of the week, mostly some of the businesses aren't willing to open because they party too hard on Sunday. They are keeping it open. And then on Monday, they are kind of laying back and relaxing. That's first thing. So on Monday, if you are going to have a full experience, it's not gonna be totally there because of that reason. And then the second thing, there is like a morning shopping kind of lifestyle. And then there is like afternoon type of lifestyle. It kind of gets slowly the shopping life is going down, and from after 12 p.m. the kind of the restaurant, the grab a drink, go out or grab the lunch kind of life is gonna start. Even some restaurants, they open around 5 p.m. which is quite late, and but that's their routine and they know their customers. I think I'm standing right in front of this mall. Perhaps I should enter. Yeah, that's what it is. look at the tower of that church, if you would be standing here, you would be amazed. Once again, you can see in the background that is leading towards the center of the city, and it is quite full of shops and other services such as fast food, restaurants, coffee shops and everything. I know that coffee shops, it's a coffee shop means a lot of things here, but when I say coffee shop, it means internationally what's referred to a coffee shop is just you go grab a coffee, sit there, open your laptop, do some editing, maybe write an email. That's what I mean. Well, if somebody is making a mistake thinking what I mean by saying coffee shop, that's their own problem. But I mean like just a genuine, straightforward coffee shop, okay? So coffee shops are also there, bars are also there. So you cannot go wrong by entering the town. But if you would listen to me, I wouldn't do that. I will still go around and still explore the amazing architecture and the amazing surrounding of this beautiful town. Here we have, right in the center of the city, a parking lot. It's a paid parking. And if you somehow accidentally forget to pay the parking ticket, it's gonna be an expensive fine that you will receive. Approximately about 140, 160 or 120 euros. Observant, very beautiful place. They also offer coffee. We have another parking lot on the right side. I'm not sure what this building is, but it seems historical. So we made a complete circle around the town and we are back right in front of the entrance to the town inside. And now it makes so much sense to go explore inside. You gotta play around first and then go inside. It's not permitted to just go directly. It's very unpleasant. Or it's a turn-off sign. What am I saying? I mean, like, it's this town is nice to explore and go around and then go inside. If you remember, we came up, we went over the bridge, and then from the other side we entered the town. This time we came around the town, and now we are entering from the right side door. Such a beauty.
Bong ka mo siya.
And if you stand here, you can look at the entrance, the door, the gate, directly from here, and it is one hell of a view. Oh, this is the door to museum. Thank you. I don't know why these bikes are thrown over each other. My first plan was to completely capture the entire town, but now that I'm walking, I kinda sort of feel before I finish the entire place, it's gonna be late because there is quite some distance in front of me to walk and the services will be slowly closing. But I wanna really bring you these vibes, but for sure I'm gonna be coming here again and making even a more detailed and even a more complete video of this place. So now we are gonna head into the like main street, shop streets, like things to see and things to eat street, and next time when I come I will cover the complete town. Also, I will leave the same map in the description so you can do it for yourself. If you remember, we were here at certain point at in front of this gelato place, this dome, and then I continued walking that way instead of going this way, and now we are gonna start walking that way. The sun is from back, so it's gonna be nice, very the lighting is gonna be nice, and still there is some life going on. But for a very detailed and a very nice, relaxed, pleasing and satisfying video, I will be coming here again as I already start to love this place. I'm still kind of following the map a little bit. There is something nice to see, to go around.
dan.
Precies achter me langs bezig.
The tower which I showed you a few minutes ago, right now we will be going right beneath the tower. Almost every place around the square is open and they have customers. Right beneath this humongous tower, holy moly, you gotta stand here and look at it. On the door you can see a woman wearing a dress. Amersfoort is one of the must visit places in the Netherlands. The vibe that it has and the terrain quality that it has and the uniqueness that it has, it is so, so beautiful. I'm pretty sure there are plenty of places like this, but this one so far is kind of becoming my favorite. That square, and we went straight and we took a right and we took another right around that square behind under the beneath the tower, and we are back at the same street, and we are back at the same street, and we can continue now. This is the same like shopping and this or highlight street of Amersfoort. Before doing the walk, somebody told me that, hey, it's gonna be late and the services are gonna be closed. And I think that's very true. Restaurants are open, but some of the other services are slowly and gradually, I can see they are like starting to close. But it would be nice to come sometime, like in the around Christmas time and a new year, to see this place also in the night time. Pesaria La Scala. Restaurant Rhodos Palace. There you go. We also have here a Greek restaurant. We have an Indian restaurant here. And a very cute, another valet to explore. Halloween. As you can see, some of the services are open, but they are indoors, or maybe it is a little bit early for people to show up. Maybe there is a nightlife here, but that's something that I have to stay for the night and I have to figure it out myself. Yeah. So right now we are walking behind this magnificent church that we saw from the front side. It is a Protestant church. So some services, look at this. Some of the services are open, they are indoors. Thank you. Look at this place. Café Under die Linde. From 1755. Holy moly. That's old. We are back at the same main street that we were. We just took a small exit to a scenery place. The food smells so good here. To be honest, there is a hell lot in this town to explore, and just to kind of slowly walk around and look at it, or maybe grab one or two things, taste something, grab a drink, all of that stuff. Maybe you find a nice comfortable place that you like, sit and kind of let the things sink in. But as I can see, not just the time, I'm running out of time, I'm running out of battery. I'm so unprepared for this video. Anyways, now I have learned my lesson. I will be carrying extra power bank with me in order to charge my camera, and in the same time I'll be early to kind of capture the entire vibe and not be late. So no more excuses. Yeah. The Far East Oysters restaurant. The rest I couldn't read, to be honest. And if you remember this wall, we were right here and we went around the town. I will show you here a very beautiful artwork that's here right in the middle of this square. Alright folks, this was it for Amers Amersfoort, not part. Hope you enjoyed the video. Today it is the 15th of October 2024. And if you did enjoy this video, give it a thumbs up and thanks for supporting me, and thanks for staying a Patreon, and thanks to those of you who've become just a Patreon. It means to me a world. No matter for how little you are becoming a Patreon, it shows your support. It kind of motivates me. So hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, then give it a thumbs up, share this video with a friend, with somebody, so it that can help the growth of the video, the growth of the channel. And that's it. Yeah, other than that, until the next time, peace.